friends. I am up at camp today with Sarah and Joyce, and we spent some time today sitting far apart, thinking about ways that we can be present with our community this summer, even though our camp is not in session. And then we took some time to clean the barn and set it up and put it together. You may know there is a prayer vigil for action happening in Providence at this moment as we speak. And while the three of us could not be there today, we wanted to hold just a small vigil of our own here from the barn in solidarity with those who are at the vigil in Providence as we pray for swift action and justice for our Black brothers and sisters in this country. And we pray for all those who have died as a result of police brutality and racism and inequality. Our plan is to light the candle, to hold silence for just shy of 9 minutes, and then we will say a quick prayer. We will stay in here and pray in the barn for the duration, but we wanted to just invite you into the silence with us. If you are someone who will also not be in the vigil today, we wanted to give you the opportunity to sit and see this space set up for worship and pray with us today. Let us pray. Loving God, in Jesus you were bullied, beaten, and killed. You are always on the side of those whose souls or bodies are mistreated. While we cannot be present with our bodies at protests and vigils right now, we stand with all those who stand up for justice. Uphold them. Keep them safe. Grant us the courage to stand beside all who are harmed by the violence of racism with our bodies and in our prayers. Give us the words to speak out for those whose breath has been taken. Enkindle in our hearts the fire of your love, that together we might end the scourge of racism that has infected our nation. Amen.